The studio secretary murder. Uh-oh. Time for another case. Another dime, another dollar. Oh my. Hello. Hello, sir. Damn, she's drunk. Oh, wow. Even she understands what's going on, though.
Yes, I'm aware that it's an election year.
Ooh.
Keep a hold of your hat, counselor. Now is not the time to lose your nerve.
Cole Phelps.
It would appear that someone has hawked a rose gold wedding ring, a matching engagement ring. Sound familiar?
Deirdre Muller.
Press the pawnbroker and see what you can find out. The address is 348 South Main Street. The Muller case goes before the grand jury next week, and the DA does not want any egg on his face. Then get out to the railroad depot on Santa Fe Avenue.
Well, is that what people do? They throw eggs at him?
Another poor unfortunate found this morning beside a railroad line. 40-year-old white woman.
Right, Skipper.
Oh, wow, she didn't look 40.
That bum
okay.
Took a swipe at me. I put him down with my sack.
With your sack? Oh.
When we're not even married.
Another body.
I guess you like it that way.
Ring. The Emperor may soon have to come to terms with the fact that he's wearing no clothes.
What exactly did you get that book of riddles shoved up your ass, Phelps? Is that what your old man paid college tuition for?
Yeah, I think he means his Captain Donnelly fuckhead. He's an idiot. Just jumps to conclusions because he's stupid. And he's an asshole and should probably just fucking kill himself. I don't know. Be honest. Alright, locations. Pawnbroker. Are we gonna go to the rail yard? Okay. I don't remember this. Pawnbroker. Okay, let's see.
You've got to admit, this is looking odd.
Anyone could pawn a ring.
But if you take it along with all of the other indicators.
Cole, Hugo Muller was identified by the school's groundkeeper.
He was?
Guy. Witnesses have figured the wrong guy before.
He ran, for God's sakes.
And he always maintained he was set up.
Yeah, but his testimony isn't really the best testimony. It's kind of why it's not valued as much these days. Now we got much better evidence out there. But it's 1947, so... whatever someone says goes. Well, not really, but thankfully, kinda. In some cases, it does. Even nowadays, it's kind of bad, I think.
Detectives Phelps and Galloway, LAPD. You have a rose gold wedding and engagement ring?
David Bremner. Ooh. I gotta get something for this pledge. Gave that bum money, now you guys are gonna leave me short.
How much did you give him?
$50.
Try another number.
20?
Try 10.
Oh,
feel
God.
Lucky you're getting it.
I have
wow.
The rings right here.
Cheapskate asshole, Rusty. God damn. Okay, why did I switch over? It was stupid.
Does this mark mean anything?
Hallmark. Gives you an idea of the quality.
Okay. What about this one? Ooh, this one looks more special.
What's this mark here?
Maker's mark, usually traceable. That one came from Hartfield's Jewelry down on Broadway.
Thanks for the tip.
All right, cool. That's it?
What have you got on the guy who brought these in?
Goes by the name of Percy B. Shelley. Gave an address. 15 Poland Street, London, Tulare County.
Can you give us a description of the man who pawned these rings?
Not sure. Medium height, medium build. Dark hair, I think. Sorry. He just had one of those forgettable faces.
We'll be in touch.
I know. I know what you mean. It's always like that with these serial killers. Alright. I mean, serial killers. What did I say? No. The suspicion's real. Oh my god.
We have a problem.
We could have the local troopers check out the Tulare County address.
The address is bogus. Purpose having fun with us. The guy who's been sending the Dahlia letters is also the guy who pawned these rings.
How do you figure that?
Percy Bysshe Shelley wrote the poem that came with the Dahlia letter. The Dahlia letters
yeah.
are genuine. The
That's
man who killed Elizabeth Short may have also killed Deirdre Muller.
And how do we prove that, Phelps? Skipper ain't gonna like this one bit.
We're gonna have to rely on this guy tripping up on his own vanity.
KDPL 20 Century, and a citizen reports a man with a gun.
Oh God.
On Grand between 4th and 5th. Any Century unit.
It's just one guy. I want to kill multiple people. I don't want to just kill one guy. With that. I'm getting sick of that. It's a waste of time. Oh my God, it's down there. God damn it. Oh my God. Turn this way, come on. Wait, was that a way to go? Oh my, whatever. Oh, come on. This game is so annoying. Hold on, do I really have to go all the way around?
Nope.
There we go. Fuck you, I'm not fucking driving all the way around for that shit. Retarded. Oh, so tell me the time. Tell me
ready?
The time.
Follow me.
What's the time? In
place. We should keep this development okay. with the rings under our hat until we speak with the captain.
We're all on the same team, Rusty.
Chain of command, Phelps. The skipper will decide who needs to know. Got it?
I get it, Rusty.
Oh God, okay. Cut me off, alright. 11:12 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. Ooh, clothed again.
Hard, isn't it?
He's doing
yeah.
clothed now.
I look after all
so
the
I don't have to worry about censoring now.
Got?
The Negro, Nelson Gaines called
oh,
the
Oh, here we go,
I came down
that
here
word
to
again.
Make sure him and the other guy,
the
Jameson,
Negro.
Stuck
Jameson found the body?
Something like that. Guy makes me sick.
We'll talk
Why?
To the coroner. Keep an eye on both of them.
Sir, we always see this guy everywhere. Do all the cops just look the same, or is D actually... Okay, we're not gonna talk to you yet. Why would we do that? Hey, Mal, how's it going?
What have we got here?
White female, approximately 40 years of age. Lipstick smudges on the face, but no writing. At least nothing legible. A blunt force trauma to the temple, nose, and eye regions. Ligature marks
Ooh.
Point to the probable cause of death being strangulation.
Any idea
cool.
of the time of death?
From her temperature, after midnight would be my guess.
Wow. Nice guess. I'm betting you're right. She was drunk. Wow, that's a smooth
smell.
Die.
Very good. There is the usual evacuation smell. But
Ooh.
It appears she's been living rough for quite some time.
Meaning she took a
Very
shit when she died.
Strong smell of alcohol.
Well, the autopsy will tell, but I would assume that she was inebriated.
Yeah, she definitely was. I already know that. All right.
Another missing ring.
Goddamn.
It seems I've been swabbing a lot of bare fingers recently.
Can you be more exact about the time of death?
No later than 2 a.m. The state the body was in, a 1 or 2 hour window is the best I can do.
Oh, wow, literally nothing happened to this hand, except that it's really pale. Alright. Wait, that's it? Oh, wow. Wait, is that it? Okay, yeah, it is it. Let's show the stupid purse. Hey, stop taking a picture of it, I need to look at it. Okay, take a picture of me, cool. Check out the purse. Hmm. What's in here? Dear Evelyn.
Someone was trying to get her to come home.
I hope this letter finds you in a better way than when we last parted. Bitter words were exchanged. You had taken too much liquor. And we both know what that makes you become. But but I'm not writing to harass and excuse and accuse. I'm writing to apologize. I was heartbroken seeing what had become of my little girl and what she's doing to herself. You are destroying your body and your soul with liquor, Evelyn. And it's hard for me to watch you, to watch, than you can imagine. But only God Almighty above us is the night to judge. And so I beg your forgiveness. I've been in contact with a sanitarium here in Connecticut on your behalf. They say your condition is an illness, Evelyn, that can be treated. You only need to check yourself in. You will not. To be continued. Cool. What's about this? The Keystone Film Company.
You go over to the lot and see what they know about her.
That's gonna be difficult, Cole. Keystone Studio lot closed back in 41.
Oh. Damn. I wonder it was only good till 41. October 31st, I said, I think. Wow. Ooh, another bar. Great. More of that shit. Oh. Okay, a message. What's this?
Maybe someone at Mensch's will remember.
Interesting. Maybe, Cole. Maybe.
This is a chit for personal items, not booze.
Two large suitcase, one small suitcase, plain bed sheet, three photo frames. Damn, statuette, make it, wow, okay. Someone really wants some shit. Oh. Well, the phone? Wait, who am I talking to? There's someone who wanted to talk. Is that you?
If you want a full report, you have to let me work.
Okay, shut up, relax. Jesus.
What are you thinking, Ray?
The city keeps tossing us dead bodies. We're just running to catch up.
Oh, okay, cool, thanks. I thought you were gonna use the useless information. No, you're useless, alright. You're just a photographer, no one cares about you. Okay, I guess we'll talk to this dude.
Detective Phelps and Galloway, homicide.
Oh, no.
Tell me exactly what happened.
We were shoving cars over to the main line when I saw this man here lying on top of this woman. The woman wasn't moving and seemed to be in a bad way.
What time was this?
About 7:30 this morning, sir.
Thanks for your help. Have you given Patrolman Hart your details?
I have, sir.
Thank you. You can go now.
I think Cole's secretly a racist. That's my personal beliefs. You don't have to agree with them. Just my personal beliefs.
Detective Phelps, LAPD homicide.
John Ferdinand Jameson.
We need you to answer some questions.
Look like Norman, man.
If you don't mind, I prefer Ferdinand.
Don't push your luck, knucklehead.
What were you doing to
this guy? Acts kind of like Norman Bates.
Are you sure you won't be upset?
Try me, Ferdinand.
I was kissing her.
Whoa, okay, Custy, what the fuck is wrong with you?
Take your beating like a man.
Fuck
you.
You
stupid
1947 idiot. God damn it. So dumb. God damn.
Classic Carmine.
Is this I'm sorry about that. No. I hate my partner too. He's
I
a fucking asshole.
Purse.
If I had a chance, I'd kill him.
Lipstick.
Rusty, stop! Don't hit him.
Fucking bitch. Alright, let's see.
You went through her purse?
It wasn't like she needed it. I took a look.
He's so stoic. He's like, he's so proud. He's so confident now. Like, yeah, that's what I did. I said that. Oh, yeah. So that must be truthful, right? I mean, I'm kind of skeptical for some reason, but. Movie law. Part of torn letter. Okay. Wait, so wait, you found it near her purse. Okay.
Did you take any money?
Wasn't any to take. I found her lipstick and her matchbook over on the mat. Not much else.
Well, there was the... there was the movie ticket and the letter and shit, but...
You found the body?
Yes, I did. I work here. I was coming off shift and headed home.
Okay, this is fishy now. See what Lai does.
Come on, Jameson. He lured this poor woman out here and killed her.
I don't think he'd be staying here if he did that.
What makes you say I killed her?
Unless he's really trying to fuck with us. I mean, damn, that would be good if he was really trying to fuck with us right now.
Nothing personal. I'm just doing my job. You understand that?
I'm pretty sure it's a doubt.
Why didn't you report the body, Jameson? Do you know how this is going to look to a jury?
A jury? What gives? I could tell that she was dead. I came through here about midnight last night. She wasn't here then.
Let me belt him again.
Oh.
You're under arrest, Jameson. We'll see how this plays out. Until then, you can think a little on how you'd like to be treated if you were found dead.
I'm telling you, it's not illegal. Me and some friends of mine...
Oh my god. Okay, shut up, Rusty.
Fine.
Jesus.
You get this sack of shit into a cell. I'll deal with him later.
Sure, Rusty.
Hey, nice day, gentlemen.
God damn, it's relaxed, dude. Fuck. So dumb. I'm sorry. I'm really embarrassed. I have to deal
with
this.
Stay out of my way, and I will stay out of yours. Everybody's happy.
How about I put a fucking gun through your fucking mouth? And then press the trigger. How'd you feel about that, huh? Huh? Huh?
Phelps, 1247.
I need an address on Levine's Liquor. Closest store to the Santa Fe Avenue rail yard, if possible.
Just a moment, Detective. Closest store would be the one at 939 South Hope Street.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you. That's all you're good for. All right. Now, let's go. I guess we're done here. Okay. Mench's Bar. Milwaukee, Wisconsin. This is American. Here we go. Ooh, next place. Okay, that's not a good way to go. Okay, whatever, I don't care. Go this way.
Read that those goddamn Chinese want to sell the relief food that we're sending them?
Yeah. Yeah, I read about that.
People are...
Watch it, will ya?
Keep talking. Don't ruin it.
Those people are starving. They can't do that.
Want to sell
Calm food. Down!
I had to open it that way. There's nothing else I could do. It wouldn't open for me.
Want to sell the food to fund the civil war against the communists.
Really? I guess that's okay, then.
Armies can't fight without food. Spend all your money on weapons, but you still have to have the will to fight. Fortunately, the Reds will win in China.
Watch your mouth. You know what you're saying?
The people of this country open to a king. You think the Chinese will balk at an emperor if they are starving?
Give me a break. Left and left and left and left again, and I'm right up your ass.
Oh, shit. Damn, Cole took some action there. Oh, damn, he actually responded now. Yeah, serves you right, Rusty, you fucking asshole. Fuck you. Alright, let's see. D.P. Smith Machine Company. Oh, God. Jeez, how far is this? Okay. Mench's Bar, right, that's where we're going. Okay. Yeah, but damn, Cole taking names. Cole kicking ass and taking names. And he's all out of bubblegum. That's for sure. I don't think Cole's chewed bubblegum once in this whole playthrough. God damn it, Cole. Chew some bubblegum, man. Chew some bubblegum. You gotta kick ass and chew bubblegum, Cole. That's how it works. Hey, move out of the way, bitch. That's right. No, you stay off the road, fucker. That's right. Alright, here we go. Another bar. This is a recurring theme, though, isn't it? Bars, bars, bars. Drunk ladies, drunk Drink ladies, fellas. Drunk ladies.
Oop. Phelps, Galloway, homicide. We need to ask you some questions concerning Evelyn Summers.
I'm Walter Mensch. Evelyn Summers? What is it now?
You knew Evelyn?
As well as I wanted to know Evelyn. She's a pain in the ass, always coming in here, cadging drinks, never had any money. She was in just a couple of nights ago.
Did she ever tell you where she was staying?
I don't know. I think she was living rough. She had that kind of stunk about her.
Who did she drink with?
A bunch of these guys. Kind of like you? Ask around.
Okay.
What's your name?
You mean like this guy? This is the only guy here?
Roger McCaffrey.
Mind if I ask you some questions, Mr. McCaffrey?
I'm just a starving writer, detective. What do you want to ask about?
Evelyn Summers, and why she was found beaten.
Wow, why are you so angry? Jesus.
In the rail depot on
What's wrong with you, Cole?
Okay. I see your point.
How well did you know her?
I can't say that I knew her.
This is how detectives operate. Just yell at your face in front of everyone.
Did you see Evelyn last night?
No, I was at home, writing.
Oh yeah, I'm sure you were. Sure you were, idiot.
Do you want to get dragged into this, McCaffrey? Do you want us to get interested in you?
She hung out with this powder puff, James Tiernan. They haunted the public library together.
How well do you know ghost, James like, going,
I know he works some kind of plebeian job at Rawlings.
They're just like, what are those idiots doing?
Rawlings. I know that place. Corner of 9th and Grand. A lot of cops pull there on Tuesday nights.
Oh, do they? I bet you do. I bet you do too, don't you, Rusty?
Do you have a criminal record, Mr. McCaffrey?
Nothing serious. I've had a few skirmishes.
Oh, okay. So tell me about them.
You want to save me some time, or do you want me to look up your file?
Industrial disputes, strikes, workers' rights.
Ooh, okay. So that's why you're a writer now.
A regular fifth columnist. Nice to meet you, comrade.
Hey, we're not in communist
Thank
Russia.
Thank you for the information, Mr. McCaffrey.
Not yet, anyway. Wait, is this it? Really? This is it? Okay. We're about back here. Okay, then. So that's really it. Just want to be sure about that. No, it's not. Hold on. What else is here? What about this guy?
You a friend of Evelyn Summers?
Oh, okay.
Who's asking?
Very cute. You know who's asking.
I know my rights. You don't have any. Answer the question. Evelyn mooches for drinks. I don't have any time for that.
Was that so
hard?
He
does, Rusty, idiot.
Keep writing me, copper.
He doesn't have time for that. What if we don't believe you? How come I didn't give truth dare there? Truth doubt. Truth dare. Truth doubt lie there, huh? Wait, it's not over yet. Hold on.
Looks like trying to enjoy a quiet drink is against the goddamn law now, huh?
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, he said he had no rights, even though he's an idiot.
Else to tell you, but I don't.
All right. What about you?
If you don't mind, I'm trying to grasp a very elusive thought.
Oh, you're so suave. Okay. So check out the back here. I don't think this matters. I feel like there's something still at this bar. Hold on. What is in this bar that I'm missing? Intuition. Show all clues. Apparently there are none to show. am I missing? Oh. No.
Help me
out.
I
say we try the liquor store next. I could get a short dog for the car.
Maybe we'll be coming back here. I don't know. Whatever. Hold on. What if we go inside the bar? I just want to be sure about this. Yeah, okay, there's nothing. Locations. Yeah, let's go to the liquor store. Fine. Sounds good. Let's go. You're driving this time. I'm
you drive. I need to go over the case notes.
I actually really am sick of this. Let's go. And if you have nothing good to say, then it's worth it.
What did you make of McCaffrey?
There'll come a day, and it's coming very soon. We'll run him and the rest of his pinko buddies out of Los Angeles.
I meant as a suspect, Rusty.
McCaffrey. Was that the guy we just spoke to? I think so, yeah. Okay. Good. Pinko. Yeah, Rusty hates literates. Because they're smarter than him. Oh, God. Business hours.
What can I do
Hello.
For you?
LAPD, Phelps and Galloway. We're making inquiries into the murder of Evelyn Summers.
Evelyn? She's dead?
You knew Evelyn Summers, Mr.
Robbins? Yes, I knew Evelyn. I was a good friend of her ex-husband. She kept some of her stuff here.
Can you show us, please?
Was her ex-husband Robin
sure.
Williams?
Come this way.
No answer? Okay, that's fine. I don't really care anyway. Let's see.
You got some fine stock here, Mr. Robin. You know, you let us take some for the road, this case might get solved a lot quicker.
Oh. Rusty.
He's joking, Mr. Robbins.
Rusty, you corrupt son of a bitch. I don't think he was joking, Cole. I don't think he was. Ooh. Look at this.
I'm guessing Evelyn hadn't held down a job for quite some time before she was killed.
What makes you get that from that plaque there? I don't understand.
When exactly did Evelyn work in the pictures?
A few years ago. She worked in legal copyrights for music.
Oh, one of those people. Okay, I see. I see. Yeah, we have problems with that these days. No. Not good. Not a good situation.
Maybe Evelyn
going
did
on
something
there.
Other than drinking her spare time.
Yeah, like, went bowling. Apparently she took one of the pins. She was like, I want this pin. Ooh. Alright, photos.
She
nice.
She wasn't always such a loner.
I guess not. This book's pro- Oh, wait,
Evelyn
this book was
reading Aristotle?
Evelyn wasn't stupid. The only stupid thing about her was her need to drink.
Oh, wait. Send look at there.
And she was borrowing books from Grosvenor McCaffrey.
Ooh. Oh, damn. Let's go look at this, too. I don't care if it's over. What do you have to say about this, Cole, huh? Huh? Don't lie, it's probably your fapping material. I know how you are, Cole Phelps. Where does this guy go? What the hell, where'd he go? Well, why'd you disappear all the way over here now? What the fuck? Hello.
We're trying to
why'd you run away from me?
Evelyn's movements yesterday.
She came by in the morning.
A social visit? To pick up some of her things?
She had a couple of bucks and bought a quart of rye.
She had a couple of bucks and about a quart of rye, is it? About a quart of rye. Oh. Okay.
Any idea where the money came from?
She didn't mention it. But she did say the booze was a present for a boy. She said they had been fighting and she had to make it up to him.
Oh. Interesting. I bet you got jealous there, didn't you?
Are you and Evelyn close, Mr. Robin?
Not many people will be sad she's gone. I'll be one of the few.
We got the impression that Evelyn had been sleeping rough of late.
It became difficult for me to have her stay here. Her mother was trying to get her back on the straight and narrow. She's old now. To be honest, you have to have a good reason to want to get back on.
I guess so.
You know a friend of Evelyn's by the name of McCaffrey?
Not personally.
Okay. He's looking away now. He's kind of okay. It's right.
You know a friend of Evelyn's by the name of McCaffrey?
Not personally.
Not personally. Okay, one more time.
You know a friend of Evelyn's by the name of McCaffrey?
Not personally.
Okay, so is that kind of dowdy, the way you just did that? Truth. If we go with truth, I mean, I feel weird about this. What is lie to?
You sure you don't know McCaffrey? The book was in your room.
I would have thought it was pretty obvious the book was among Evelyn's things. You think you have some way to link me to McCaffrey?
Why do you phrase it like that? Like as if you're like really guilty of it or something. And I have to go out of my way to prove it. You know? Let's see.
Looks like I made a mistake.
So you don't know him personally, okay.
You know a friend of Evelyn's by the name of McCaffrey?
Not personally.
Okay, but you do. So you've heard of him.
She talked about
goddammit.
Supposedly he fought in the International Brigade in Spain and in the miners' strikes back in Virginia.
Thanks for your help, Mr. Robbins.
No okay, problem. Then. Yeah, thanks for being not upfront about that for some fucking reason.
I'd like to make arrangements for the funeral. You think I could get in touch with Evelyn's mother?
Put in a God call damn, I had a feeling that'd be doubt. Fuck. Mr. Robbins. We'll be trying fuck. To the next of kin.
Thanks. Get the guy, huh? Evelyn never hurt anybody.
Why didn't you just tell me if you knew him? Fuck, you asshole. Make things easier for me. I'm tempted to go back just to fuck you over, you piece of shit, but I won't. I gotta stay fair and honest with this playthrough. Even though I did it like twice, but I'm not doing it anymore. I made that my goal.
Car 11K, Car 11 King, KGPL.